हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो वेलकम अगेन. अनदर लेक्चर, अनदर प्रॉब्लम ऑन प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेन्स. दिस टाइम आई एम टेकिंग ए प्रॉब्लम. द प्रॉब्लम विल बी लाइक दिस. द प्रॉब्लम विल बी एज लाइक दिस. ए स्क्वायर ए बी सी डी ऑफ 50 mm साइड हैज इट्स कॉर्नर ए इन द एच पी एंड इट्स डायगनल ए सी इज इंक्लाइंड एट 30 degrees टू द एच पी एंड द डायगनल बी सी इंक्लाइंड एट 45 degrees टू द वी पी and parallel to the HP. Draw its projection. This is one of the very interesting problem. As you remember that earlier, most of the time I told you that in the problems of projection of planes, the surface word will almost come most of the times. But in this particular problem, there is no reference of the surface word. But as you know that when we solve the problems of oblique planes, once we will make the surface inclined to one of the reference plane and later on one of the part of the plane, that may be the side, may be the diagonal, may be the diameter of the plane, will be inclined to the other plane. So if I am making some part of the plane inclined to the reference plane, the surface is also going to be inclined to the reference plane. But in this particular problem, they have not referred about surface, but instead of that, both the times we are going to make this plane inclined to the reference plane with the help of the diagonals. Firstly with the diagonal AC and later on with the diagonal BD. Now how we will decide that which diagonal we are going to make inclined to the reference plane first? So if you look at this problem, they are saying that one of the corner will be in the HP. So that point will be always helping me. They are saying corner A in the HP and diagonal AC will be inclined 30 degrees to the HP. So what I have decided that initially I am going to make the diagonal AC inclined to the HP. This object will be like this. This is a square. If I normally hold like this, now the sides are parallel to the HP and perpendicular to the HP. But if I hold it like this and suppose this will be A corner, this is B. Now look at the position of AC. That is right now at it, this is parallel to HP and this BD will be perpendicular to HP. So in the corner concept, as they have mentioned about the corner, as you know that in the case of plane, either we will make the plane inclined with holding one of the side or maybe one of the corner. So this is the problem of the corner concept. In this they are saying one of the corner on HP, so better option will be I will keep the whole plane on the HP and by keeping this diagonal AC parallel to the VP. So that is the concept. What is the concept? If I want to keep one of that corner on the HP and the same diagonal inclined to the HP, so what I have decided, I am going to keep the whole plane on the HP with diagonal AC parallel to the VP like this. So the top view will be like this. Now after drawing the top view, that will be a square. In extreme corner, I will get this corner A dash. So now holding this corner, I will rotate it like this. So when I will rotate it like this, this diagonal AC will be inclined at 30 degrees to HP. And when the AC will be inclined, automatically the surface is also going to be inclined. So with the help of this AC diagonal, I am going to make this surface inclined to HP by this. So instead of surface, what they have used the word that will be AC. So what I have to start now drawing this figure. I will keep my square at 45 degrees inclined to the XY like this. So I will draw a square ABCD in the top view. So this point will be small a, this will be B, this is C and this will be D and its front view. That will be a line. As I have kept the plane on the HP, so the front view will be on the XY line, A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash. So this is the initial position. I hope you understand the concept. So using the corner concept, I have drawn this square. Now I will dimension this. This is 50 mm. So in the initial simple position, I have kept the whole plane on the HP with diagonal AC parallel to the VP. That is the concept. Now in the second stage, I am going to keep this A dash on the XY line. I will rotate this by 30 degree. So in the next figure, this will be rotated like this. Make it inclined to HP by 30 degree. Now as you know that when we rotate it by from the HP, the length of the front view is not going to change. So I will pick the same distance from the first figure, that is A dash, C dash, and in between the mark this point, that is also B dash. So this is A dash, B dash, C dash, and D dash. Now the surface will be inclined to HP by 30 degree. Now with the help of this front view, we will draw the top view. As you know that the distances of the top view is not going to change again. So the same distance I am going to carry forward further. So I will draw parallel lines, parallel from these points. And from the bottom also. Now draw perpendiculars from upside. So draw perpendiculars on the figure. You can easily get the top view. Figure will be compressed, but as you know that the symmetry will remain there. So just taking precautions. So in the top view, we will got all these points. So this will be A, then this is B, this is C, and this is D. Join these points with the help of straight lines. You can easily get the next figure. Now look at the position. Now the surface of the plane will be inclined to HP, or you can also say that the diagonal AC will be inclined to HP by 30 degree. And what is the position of the BD? Look at the diagonal BD, that is perpendicular to VP. Perpendicular to VP means parallel to HP. So that is also the initially position. I have positioned it like this so that AC will be parallel to VP, so BD will be perpendicular to VP. So perpendicular to VP is also parallel to HP. So now in the next stage, what I am going to do, I am going to make this BD incline 45 degree to the VP. So that is the third stage. If you look at this figure, in the space initially we started like this. Now I have rotated it like this by 30 degree. Now keeping AC fixed, I will rotate it like this. So this BD will be inclined 45 degree to the VP. Right now BD will be perpendicular to VP, so I am rotating it like this. So the BD will be inclined 45 degree to the VP, and we will copy the top view. As you know that when I make it inclined to VP by some angle, the shape of the top view is not going to change again. The front view is going to change. So in the next figure, I am going to copy the same figure. So in the third stage, I am going to copy the figure by making this BD inclined at 45 degree to the VP. So I will mark any point here and draw a line perpendicular to make the 45 degree angle with the help of geometry. I am going to copy this. So this angle will be 45 degree. Even I can little. I will choose this point, another point I have chosen. Now I will make it inclined by 45 degree. So like this. So this line will be at 45 degree to the XY. On this line I am going to place this diagonal BD. So pick this BD from here, from this figure, and copy this BD. So this is the point B and this is the point D. Now with reference to that, I will copy the whole figure. If I draw a perpendicular from the midpoint of BD even I can use the arc also. And I can double check the figure will be copied same or not. So this length will be equals to this length and this length will be equals to this one. So that is the point. I have got all the four points. So this is A, this is B, C and D. Join those points with the help of straight lines. You can easily get the figure. Now look at the figure. Now the diagonal BD will be inclined 45 degree to the VP. Now with the help of this top view, I will draw the front view. As you know that the distance of the front view are not going to change again. So I will draw parallel lines from these points in the front view. One locus will be on the XY line. So XY will be also our locus line. So these three points. Now I will draw perpendiculars from ABCD, perpendicular upside. So this is the point C. This is point A. And upside there will be point B. So I can easily get these points. This will be A dash. This is B dash, C dash and D dash. Join all those points with the help of straight lines. You can get the front view of the given square. Now look at the final solution. As they told us, the diagonal AC will be inclined 30 degree to the HP, that is seen in this figure, and one of the corner on the HP, that is A dash, and diagonal BD will be inclined to VP by some angle 45 degree. So this is one of the very interesting problem. I hope you understand the concept. I have drawn in front of you. Try to draw this in your sketchbook or drawing sheet. Thank you. Thank you very much.